There are several other videos I should be working on right now, but I'm making this video instead because I'm annoyed and I'm fed up. One of the few recent YouTube policy changes that actually seemed to make sense was announced on the official YouTube creator blog back on August 15th, 2019. That's when they said that YouTube CEO Susan Wojcicki, or however you pronounce her last name, shared that improving creators' experience with copyright claims was one of YouTube's top priorities, and they said that one concerning trend they saw was aggressive manual claiming of very short music clips used in monetized videos. They even admit these claims can feel particularly unfair as they transfer all revenue from the creator to the claimant regardless of the amount of music claimed. So they announced changes to their manual claiming policies intended to improve fairness in the creator ecosystem. They said, going forward, our policies will forbid copyright owners from using our manual claiming tool to monetize creator videos with very short or unintentional uses of music. They didn't define what they meant by very short, but in this article from The Verge, which quoted YouTube's Director of Creative Product Management, David Rosenstein, he said it referred to single-digit seconds, so basically anything under 10 seconds. And YouTube announced that this new policy would go into effect beginning in mid-September. Well, today is September 25th, so that's past mid-September. And I got this email from YouTube announcing that a copyright claim was created for content in my 1985 Sony Walkman video, which I uploaded back in 2013. It says the copyrighted content was a One Direction song claimed by Sony Music Entertainment. And if I look up that video in my video manager, indeed it says that there is a copyright claim on the video, and it also says ads might appear on the video and I cannot monetize it. But if we look at the details, it says there's a sound recording manually detected, and the timestamp it gives is 5 minutes 11 seconds to 5 minutes 18 seconds. Now if my math is correct, that is 7 seconds of music that was manually claimed by Sony Music Entertainment in violation of this new policy announced by YouTube, which prevents such very short claims from being manually claimed as of mid-September. So YouTube is not even following their own announced policies here and allowing these claims to still be put onto videos. And indeed, if I watch that video right now, there are ads on it, but those are not from me because I'm being prevented from monetizing it. Those ads were put there by Sony Music Entertainment because of their copyright claim on it. You can see the details of the claim listed under the description. And going back to YouTube's blog post, it said, once we start enforcement, which again was supposed to begin in mid-September, copyright owners who repeatedly fail to adhere to these policies will have their access to manual claiming suspended. So let's hold YouTube accountable to what they said. If you receive one of these manually detected copyright claims for a very short piece of music under 10 seconds, file a dispute against it and choose whichever option is applicable to your video. In this case, it's fair use. And in the explanation, this is what you should write. I'll put this in the description of this video so you can cut and paste it. This claim is in violation of YouTube's policy forbidding copyright owners from using the manual claiming tool to monetize creator videos with very short or unintentional uses of music. Copyright owners who repeatedly fail to adhere to this policy will have their access to manual claiming suspended. I basically just copy that wording directly from YouTube's announcement, so I think that's the most effective way to do this. And then submit your dispute, and let me know in the comments if you have had to dispute a manually detected copyright claim from Sony Music Entertainment of a very short piece of music. Maybe if there's enough of us, we can get their ability to manually claim videos removed. Or at least maybe we could if the system was actually working. Every time I try to dispute this claim, if I do it using the new YouTube Studio beta, which by the way puts you through additional questioning to try to prevent you from filing a dispute, it just says unable to submit a claim dispute. And if I try to file the dispute using the old Creator Studio in Firefox, it just gives me their monkey error. So good going, YouTube. You can't even file a dispute at all. So I'll keep trying to file this dispute, and I'll let you know in a future video what ends up happening with this copyright claim that shouldn't even have happened in the first place.
What if your theory's wrong? I don't know the meaning of the word wrong. There's a shocker.